Hello everyone, this is Sonny with avnavarna.com. What you're looking at here is a live screen recording of the monitoring view meter from the web interface of my StormAudio MK3 processor. On the left side of the screen, on the right, you see the tone generator from Room EQ Wizard. Our plan here is to monitor the output of the various speakers in my system and see how the speakers interact with the Direct Live ART active room treatment, as well as how the Auro-Matic upmix interacts with the speakers. Looking at the view meter, you can see my system has 24 channels. As you see, my mouse move circle around those channels. This is a 9.1.6 configuration, with the 0.1 being 8 subwoofers and a bass shaker system. The Storm Audio configurator labels it as a 9.9.0.6 system, simply because I don't use the height channels, that is the 0.0. I use Atmos overhead ceiling speakers. There's 6 of those. There's 9 bass layers, and then, of course, the subwoofers. Maybe just a little bit confusing at first. If you see the front left here is channel 4. The front right is channel 17 mixed in over here with the subs. I do that because my channel 4 on the back of the processor is closest to my left amp. Channel 17 is closest to my right amp. Going to use the Room EQ Wizard tone generator to generate sine waves so that we can see how the various frequencies are handled by the MK3 processor. And we're going to start with a baseline preset here. You see these presets on the drop-down menu. Baseline is basically the preset that I have that has no Direct Live processing. It's a raw output with a few PEQ filters to cut some of the peaks and a few of the subwoofers. And it includes appropriate crossovers for the speakers, which in this case, I have them all set to 80 Hertz. The crossover settings ultimately won't matter because I don't use this preset for listening to music or watching movies. I use Direct Live ART, and it ignores the crossover settings. However, it does retain the PEQ filters that I set up in the baseline as long as I start my Direct Live calibration with the baseline preset. So starting with a 50 Hertz tone, you can see the input here, the two-channel left and right input. That's what we're using, two-channel input at this time, left front, right front, and the subwoofers. Bass shakers are showing output, but that's simply because it's feeding the bass shaker amp. As we move up in frequency, nothing really changes other than the subwoofers start to disappear because they are crossed over at 80 Hertz. And as it rolls off, I think it's a minus 12 dB octave, they'll eventually disappear. So let's kick in Direct Live ART. I have a lot of presets. I'm just going to use my music preset. This will give us an idea of what ART is doing and what speakers it's using. ART uses other speakers to support speakers that aren't able to produce the low frequency response, or could also be using other speakers to offset room decay. There's several internal functions and technical things going on, which you can read about on the Dirac Live website. But for this sake of this test, you can see what's happening here at 80 Hertz as we move the frequency up. It may change. The output of each speaker will vary depending on what support is needed for the front speakers. But all the speakers in ART active room treatment are used to support the front speakers. That's the way I have this particular preset set up. As we go through the frequency response, you see how the levels change, again, based on what support the front speakers need from that particular frequency, whether it be room decay or support from other speakers. As you get on up to 250 Hertz, you really don't see any effect anymore because the Direct Live ART cuts off at 150 Hertz, so there is no effect. Now we'll move into the Storm Audio Auro-Matic, which is basically Auro3D's Auro-Matic upmixer for this particular processor and several other processors. We'll use baseline on this simply because We don't want to see what ART is doing with these other speakers. We just want to see what Storm Audio's Auro-Matic is doing. So again, we'll start at a lower frequency, the sine wave at 125 hertz. Again, you see the two-channel input with the two front speakers and the subs. We're going to kick in Auro-Matic. At first, you won't see any change whatsoever in this because I have the Auro strength set to zero. In the Auro-Matic settings, you have two settings to select from. Auro presets, small, medium, large. I'm using small. You can experiment with those for yourself. I like small because it has better imaging, tighter imaging, closer to what my regular two-channel system produces. The strength setting is from 0 to 15, 0 being no effect, 15 being the strongest. Generally speaking, I'm preferring something in between 5 and 7 in most cases. Of course, again, that's something you'll experiment with. As we go up in strength from 0 at 125 hertz, you see the top speakers start to come into effect here. I'm at strength of 10 right now. We'll go all the way up to 15 just to kind of show you what's happening there. As you can see, with the two-channel input, the only extra channels that Storm Audio's Auro-Matic is using is the top speakers, mainly the front speakers. Auro-3D is designed more for keeping the soundstage towards the front, the imaging towards the front, so that's probably why we're going to see more output from the top front speakers than we would the other speakers. Again, the top speakers only and two-channel. There. We're going to go back to baseline again because we're just going to look at what Storm Audio is doing with a multi-channel input. The native input is DTS HD.
And 7.1 channel surround.
You can see the center channel, the left and right surround, left and right back surround speakers, the front speakers, and the subwoofers. As we change that over to Auro-Matic, have a strength of 15 set. Let's drop that down to 0. And what you're going to notice is the Auro-Matic in this case is using the top speakers and the back surround speakers because it now has the back surround speakers zeroed. As I increase the strength, you're going to see I'm at 8 right now. You're going to see the back surrounds and the top speakers start coming into play. I'm going to raise that all the way to 15 just so you can get an idea of what's going on with the multi-channel input. There'll be a whole lot more about this in my review that I'll be posting of the Storm Audio MK3 processor that I have that I've been playing around with for about a year and a half now. There'll be a lot more about it in the review that we'll discuss. I hope this has at least been a little bit helpful for you to be able to see what's going on with the support speakers with active room treatment and what's going on with the other speakers that Auro-Matic is using in the system. Keep an eye out for that upcoming review on avnirvana.com. Hopefully in the next week or so, I plan to include some information and imaging from the setup of the unit as well as the direct live ART. So hopefully it'll be an interesting review. Thanks for watching. Remember to click that like button below. And if you're not a YouTube subscriber, please be sure to subscribe to the AV Nirvana channel. Have a great day. Thanks.